Hey everyone, welcome to my video series on the most downloaded Flipper Zero apps from lab.flipper.net. Today we'll look at 20 applications starting at the 50th most popular app. If you want to discover even more apps, you can click here to start the countdown from 100. Talking Sasquatch released the top 10 Flipper Zero apps you need to install, so be sure to give that a look too. Let's get started.
Number 50, HC11 Modem. Configure how you want to communicate with your HC11 device. And then use USB serial pass-through, which will allow your USB port to act like an HC11 modem. On your HC11, you'll want to use the AT plus FU3 command. I'll use a second Flipper Zero to simulate the module. And you can see our Flipper Zero is able to both send and receive messages from the HC11 module. And on the Flipper screen, you see how many bytes have been sent and received. Number 49, T-Rex Runner. If you've ever tried Google Chrome without the internet, you're probably familiar with this game. Number 48, VIN Decoder. Enter your 17-character vehicle identification number and find out the manufacturer and year of the vehicle. Number 47, Barcode Scanner E. This application emulates a barcode scanner for testing cash registers with the USB port. Number 46, Authenticator. Enter your PIN using the D-pad. Select the account you want to use, such as our AOL account, and then you can manually type the 6-digit code, or if your computer is connected to your Flipper Zero, just press the OK button to have it type the 6-digit code for you.
You've got mail.
Number 45, Morse Code. Number 44, UART Terminal. Connect TX, RX, and ground of your Flipper Zero to a device such as this router, and then click Open Port. Go ahead and connect power to our router, and you can see data getting sent from our router that were displayed on the Flipper Zero. In the application, you can also go to Send Command and then enter text to send to the UART device. I'll type in the Help command. And you can see that response coming back from our device. So this application is super useful for hardware hacking. Number 43, MyFair Classic Editor. Choose a saved MyFairClassic.nfc file, and then you're able to select which sector you want to view or edit, and then the blocks are displayed along with the UID, the BCC, the manufacture bytes, key A and B, and the access bits and user byte. So I'll go ahead and take a look at that second key. There it is. Next, we'll take a look at the card's unique ID. There it is. And we could edit that here, but we can also go to block 0 and say edit, and go ahead and say continue and edit any of the block 0 information. I'll go ahead and change that to an A and then say save. And now when we go down and look at our UID, you'll see that it's changed to A2 instead. And our BCC is now not correct. There's a mismatch. And really cool is you can just click OK and it will fix the BCC to be the correct value. Then as we click back to exit, we get the, do we want to save these changes? Number 42, Tetris. This game unfortunately does not have sound, But it's still a fun game to play. Number 41, QR code. I have my FlipBip wallet stored along with various URLs such as my YouTube channel, my Ko-fi channel, and also the guest Wi-Fi access. And then you can just scan that QR code with your mobile phone. And there's the website. And there I am. And there's my Ko-fi site. Number 40, T5577 Raw Writer. I have a bunch of videos that cover the T5577, such as video 107 that talks about the file format. And in here, you're able to set your modulation along with your clock speed, the number of blocks, and then you can choose which block you want to edit. So I'll go ahead and edit block 3 and go into block data, click OK. And from video 107, we learned that the block 3 that we want for our H10301 card is A9, 6A, 99, 5A. So I'll go ahead and type in that data. And then the tricky part about this application is it doesn't actually know if it's written it correctly to the T5577 tag. So you got to put it over the tag and then hopefully have it in the right position when you click write and it says it's writing and then it's finished. And then we'll try to read that tag using our second flipper and move it around here a little bit. And there's our data. Number 39, enhanced sub-gigahertz chat. This supports various ways to do encrypted chat. And you can also do a no encryption chat if you want to communicate between Flipper Zero and one that's just running the standard CLI chat application. You can see above that it says that my Flipper has joined the chat since I'm using the same password as the Flipper above. And when I go ahead and send test, you can see that message as well. Number 38, calculator. Let's go ahead and we'll try 1 plus 2 times 3. Number 37, NFC URL. Go ahead and click on new. And you can see there's a variety of URLs we can create. We'll create an HTTPS URL. And this has a custom keyboard, which has that caret next to the save button that lets us toggle between letters and symbols. Once you've created your URL, you can go ahead to options and save it to use later or export it as an NFC file that you can write to a custom tag. And you can also just say use to emulate that tag. And then just tap the back of your flipper on your phone. Number 36, Orgasmatron. Number 35, Metro Flip. This supports a wide variety of Metro cards, and if your card isn't supported, it will say card currently unsupported. I have a saved card that we can take a look at. Go ahead and parse that. And then we'll scroll through the transactions to the right to where the card was purchased. And here you can see the 1,000 credits were put on the card. And then here you can see the rail information along with the deduction. And then another rail as well. Number 34, text viewer. I'll go ahead and go into bad USB and open this test mouse file. And here you're able to read what the script is doing. So this is helpful for reviewing what a script's code is doing before you run it, or reviewing any of the text-based files that are saved on the Flipper Zero. Number 33, Quack. Quack supports variety of access, including sub-gigahertz, RFID, infrared, NFC, and iButton. You can organize all of your stuff into various folders and subfolders. My numbers are infrared, and the outlet is sub-gigahertz. Number 32, Xbox Controller. You can use your Flipper's infrared to send up, down, left, right, A and B signals to your Xbox One. It also supports the power signal if you want to turn off the Xbox. Number 31, ProtoView. This application helps you visualize sub-gigahertz signals, and you can zoom in and out of those signals so we can see that repetitive signal there. And there's additional options you can go to save that signal and to send the signal to make sure you have a valid capture. Please like and subscribe. And leave a comment below letting me know which application is your favorite Flipper Zero application.